this is Barista Barbarian. We haven't seen each other in a while. I'm still alive, and today we're having a Russian-style beer review, and we're drinking Stepan Razin. As you can tell, this is a typical barbaric Russian. He has his arms crossed. Some idiots think it's like a protective thing, but it's if you want to look cool, that's how you stand. If you remember, we had a video about baklava. However, now Russia has gone sissy a little bit. I guess it has to do with Trump being involved in our elections. If you haven't heard, Trump tried to influence our elections. So now they make sissy baklavas. They're smaller than normal baklavas, but you know, we can still drink it.
This children baklava, what in the day we call children baklava, now it's for adults too.
Yeah, this is what you start with. If you're like in grade 5, I guess that's what you start
so
with.
So I guess we left with just starter and no advanced and intermediate and you know.
Yes, but you know.
I hope the beer is still authentic because it should be. Otherwise, what's the point?
Yes.
So you can use... No?
Are you crazy?
Of course, I tried to test the boys, but of course he...
First rule of barbaric beer drinking, no
this
glasses.
Throw it away.
Yes. No. Throw it away, please. You drink out of a bottle because that way you get all the spirit in it, both metaphorically and literally. So, let's review this thing.
The metaphoric gin and juice.
So, I guess the color... you can tell, because the bottle was brown. So.
But it's well protected from the sun. However, I'm afraid there's not much to protect.
Yes, but brewed in St. Petersburg. So we're in St. Petersburg, Leningrad, if you didn't know. The most barbaric... Siberians can argue all they want, but in a normal part of Russia, it's the most barbaric, compared to Moscow at least. Anyway, let's smell this shit.
Okay, yeah, I want to smell too.
Smells like boozy water. That's what it smells
so
like.
It should be. It's like you put, you know, like homeopathic medicine.
Mm-hmm.
You put one drop in like a big tank.
Yes.
So
yes.
Here it's similar, but with malt, so bread, but little bit. Big water.
You know, it smells like policlinica. What's it called? Like.
Walking clinic, I guess.
Walking clinic,
yes.
So like polyclinica. Polyclinic.
Polyclinic.
Multi-clinic.
It's a bunch of clinics in
anyway,
one.
Anyway, while smelling it, as you know, it's too sissy, so let's chug. I'm afraid not only the bottle has gone sissy, but the beer also. It's kind of sissy-ish now.
Is this really beer?
It's not as boozy anymore. It's
no.
Not too good.
We forgot to mention very important information like the alcohol. In Russia, you don't really care because if you don't have alcohol, then you have problem. But if you have, you don't care if it's 2, 5 or 7. In this case, very small letter, but 4.7. So it's like water for us.
Yes, but it tastes more than 4.7. It's not as boozy, but it's the funny thing is, I guess you can taste the alcohol in it.
It's like they put a little bit of beer in a big tank and a lot of spirit or
yes.
Spirit.
Yes.
Alcohol. And then they said, okay, too much, we put a little bit of water more.
I don't know, Putin should look into it, or Trump, you know, both of our presidents should look into it. Anyway, well, what can you say about the taste?
I think we have too much light for this beer to be appreciated properly. But
well, I can say it's watery, but it has like a cherry like aftertaste. Check it out.
Cherry.
I think it's like cherry or you know like barbaric cherry, not like sissy cherry. Of course.
Sour cherry.
No, not like sour cherry, like regular cherry, but just barbaric.
A little bit of lemonade aftertaste.
Lemon.
Well, lemonade. But not not like real lemonade, but Soviet lemonade that has nothing to do with lemons. We have cat here as well.
How much would you give it?
I would give it 3 burps out of 10. No, maybe 4 out of 10. No?
4 burps out of 10? Well, it depends. In terms of poila,
this is like a 7. In terms of poila. In terms of like beer, this is like, well, remember, there is not like one beer, it's like CC beer and barbaric beer. As a barbaric beer, there is no rating. Like, if it helps you to stay alive, which I think it does.
I think in winter it's too mild, but maybe now in summer, well, it's not summer anymore.
You know what's strange? You drink it, it's like a light beer, but it gives you like a warm feeling.
So,
like,
it's mid-season, I would say, mid-season.
It's like Siberian wildfire in my chest a little bit, which is strange considering it's like 5-4 something.
Yes. It's made in 1795, yes, no?
Yeah, this actual beer is from that time. It's not like the brand from that, it's this actual beer from that time, if you didn't know.
Not too bad.
It helps me to stay alive, I will say. So, if you're ever in Russia and you...
How much was it? I don't know, but not very expensive.
It's not expensive at all. Of course, you can buy for the same price maybe some good beer, but it's gonna be CC beer. So if you want real barbaric experience in Leningrad and St. Petersburg, you need to come and drink real beer. Охота крепкая also pretty good, but this is the best, I think.
And the best is to get haircut like this as well. Not CC barber shops, but...
Well, it doesn't matter what haircut, it's just as long as it's not cut. Almost like if you, I don't know, like bite it with your teeth, that's the real haircut.
Or the cat do the job.
Well, yes. Mm. Well, anyway, this was an experience. I'm not gonna say good or bad, just it was an experience. So, check back with me and maybe sometime Denis to see if we're still alive. But I'm definitely gonna be alive because there is a lot of this in stores. So, see you later. Bye-bye.